Hello and welcome to this new lesson. In the last lesson, you've used objects of classes that other people have created. In this lesson, you will learn how to write your own classes. We'll start out with a class that models a car that drives along. When you design a class, the first thing you ask yourself is, what can one do with the objects? Well, imagine a car object. It can drive. Being a car, one will need to add gas once in a while. The object should be able to tell us how many miles it has driven, and also how much gas is left. That's all that our car objects will be able to do. Now the first step is to take this English description of the car's capabilities and turn it into the Java code for the public interface. Here is how I like to do it. I first imagine myself being a user of this class. So I'd have an object, here's my car, and here's how I might want to call the addGas method. The name of the method, addGas, and here I'd add 20 gallons. To make the car drive, call the drive method on the car, and of course one has to say for how long to drive, and here we say 100 miles. And then I might want to find out how much gas is left in the tank after that, so I again use the MyCar object, invoke the getGasInTank method. It returns the gas level, and I store that in a variable. Well, what's the point? I now have more information. I can see that these two methods take arguments, and this one doesn't. And I can see that this method here returns a value, and that's actually a number, and these two don't. Now it's fairly easy to write up the public interface of the class. I have four methods. Here you see their names. You see that the first two methods have parameter variables, and you see that these two methods return values. Let's see more closely on how this process works. Look at the addGas method here. Here we see it takes an argument, the number of gallons added. I've called that here the amount, and it's of type double. This method doesn't return any value, so it's declared as a void. In contrast, getGasInTank has no arguments, so there's no parameter variable here, but it returns a number, so we put the keyword double here. So the general process when designing a class is to first informally figure out what you want the class to do, then to put yourselves in the shoe of the user of the class and see how those methods might be called, and then you have enough information to write up the public interface in Java. Sarah is going to practice that process with you with another class.